I'm basically working with the pencils and the clay and working on the detail and texture down in the studio down in Garry Hill. I suppose the biggest challenge was having enough pencils for a start, and then I'm embedding the pencils into wet clay, which was the best way to work. But the big challenge was when I first did that, the pencils started splitting because of the moisture. So I had to find a way to seal the pencils to make sure that that didn't happen. So there's been a bit of trial and error in getting it right. What I've actually really enjoyed is I'd often be working away on my own down in the studio, and I've enjoyed just lifting up a pencil and about to put it on a piece and go, oh, I remember the child who gave me that one. You know, the way it's scratched, or the way there's a little bit of tape on it, or the way it's bitten. And I've enjoyed, you know, the way a child would to chew their pencil. I've enjoyed just working with something that belonged to somebody. Enda went through all the writing. When we did the workshops, every child and every person wrote either a letter, or it could have been a drawing, it could have been a piece of prose. And Enda actually painstakingly, well, I think she enjoyed it actually, but she went through everything, it was all 200, and picked out a line from each person. For the piece, I only need about 40, 45. I selected about 40 from that, which kind of encapsulated a sense of what we got from the workshops. This text has been transferred onto this kind of etched rubber to show a kind of an impression on the piece. And I think this was important to allow, when somebody sees the end sculpture, that it allows them to kind of enter into the piece a little bit more and help with their own imagination in terms of what might be inside, or an aspect of what the work is about. When we worked in Lourdes Daycare Centre, a lot of the people there, who were all quite elderly, they weren't that comfortable about writing themselves. But what they really enjoyed was the conversation. So what we did is we recorded the conversation and then I transcribed it. But then what was really nice is we got some of the children in the schools to actually write what they had said in letter form that will be put in the time capsule. So it was a very nice link between the two generations to allow the younger people to write what the older people had written. One of the things when I'm working using real pencils and the molds, I mean, you do get lovely texture and detail on each individual pencil, so you really get a sense of an individual pencil in terms of the little bit of metal at the rubber and the Faber-Castell or 2B. But on top of that, the final part of the project is that all the names of all the people who were involved, just the first names of all the people who were involved, will be stamped onto the sculpture on the pencils. So what I have done is I've gathered all the first names of all the people involved, which would be about 200. It was always the kind of part of the idea was to show what a diverse society we now live in here in Ireland. And it's culturally very diverse, and people from all over the world now live here, and Ireland is their home. And in a way, showing first names was important because it's timeless, and there's always going to be an Ava, and there's always going to be an Alexei, and a Wiltoria, and a Flavius, and an Abdullahi. So there's always going to be people from all these countries living in Ireland, so hopefully it'll speak to people in the future, and not just to those 200 people. I think it's the case with a lot of artists that we have to take a certain chance and a certain risk when we come up with an idea. And I myself, even though I was confident that there was a way, when I actually start to see it coming together, there's a certain sense of, I guess, relief. But, you know, I get more excited about it because I can kind of imagine. So I think that's one of the exciting things about working in this way, in that every project is a kind of new adventure and you don't quite know where it's going to go. And in a way, that's what you want, because it would be, in a way, a piece would be kind of dead if you kind of knew what was going to happen. But because it's unfolding, there's a freshness to it.